free convection or natural convection originates when a body force, gravity, acts on a fluid containing density gradients that are caused by temperature differences. A typical example is a heated vertical plate in a quiescent or still fluid. So here's our plate, whose surface temperature is greater than that of the surrounding air. So T surface is greater than T infinity. Because density decreases with an increase in temperature, the fluid is going to be less dense nearer the plate. And so what happens then, here's the fluid. The fluid will then rise due to these buoyancy forces. We have our determining dimensionless parameter that describes free convection is known as the Grashof number. The Grashof number is similar to the Reynolds number in forced convection. Our G is gravity. Beta is known as the thermal expansion coefficient, which we'll talk about when we do some example problems. And then, as you can see, the rest of these are delta T here. It's between the surface of the plate and the air or whatever fluid it is outside. The length of the plate divided by our kinematic viscosity squared. What this number is, it's a ratio of the buoyancy forces to the viscous force. So a higher Grashof number would indicate a larger presence of free convection. Another important parameter is the Rayleigh number, which is actually equal to the Grashof number times the Prandtl number. Just as a note that Prandtl number, which is considered a dimensionless parameter because it's the ratio of the momentum and thermal diffusivities, because it's dependent only on the fluid, i.e. there's no length scale, it's considered to be a property and we look it up. So this number is used to determine the transition, the Rayleigh number, from laminar to turbulent flow. If the Rayleigh number is greater, we have turbulent flow. So correlations for free convection are all functions of the Rayleigh number. So let's look at some correlations for simple geometries. Probably the most general of the correlations for finding the Nusselt number, and again, in any convective heat transfer problem, our ultimate goal is to find this so we can use Newton's law of cooling. In order to find our H, we need to find our Nusselt number, which is a dimensionless parameter, and this is equal to H times the length scale, whatever that is, which I'll put as L here, divided by the thermal conductivity of the fluid. As I said, probably the most general correlation for the Nusselt number is some constant times the Rayleigh number raised to some n. So these constants C and n can be looked up, but in general, n equals 1/4 if the flow is laminar, and it equals 1/3 if the flow is turbulent. In addition, for laminar flow, our C equals 0.59, and for turbulent flow, it equals 0.10. A more suitable correlation that can be used for both turbulent and laminar flow for a vertical plate is as follows. And what makes this particular correlation useful is that it can be used over the entire range of the Rayleigh number. However, we can get an even more accurate correlation just for laminar flow by using this one. The thing to keep in mind, however, that in order to use this, the Rayleigh number has to be less than 10 to the ninth. So, of course, we have different correlations, other ones depending on the geometry. And one of these is for a horizontal plate. So the ones that we were looking at before were vertical plates. Now we're looking at horizontal. But here we have different choices. First, it could be whether the plate is hotter or colder than the quiescent air, and then which side of the plate is up. So some typical correlations include those below. So these first two right here are for horizontal plates where it's either the upper surface of a heated plate, in other words, the temperature of the plate surface is greater than that of the outside fluid, or the lower surface of a cooled plate. And these are used for different values of the Rayleigh number. For the other two situations, you only have one correlation. So this is the lower surface now of the hot plate or the upper surface of the cold plate. In addition, we have correlations for long horizontal cylinders as well as spheres. So here we have that long horizontal cylinder. And here we have the correlation below for the sphere. And one of the things that you might notice compared to other forms of convection, except for the vertical plate, there's really only one choice that we're given to use to find our Nusselt number and therefore our heat transfer coefficient and then our heat transfer. So the secret to solving these free convection problems is, first of all, to determine whether there is free convection. So there are two things you should look for. Obviously, the surface temperature has to be different than the surrounding fluid. The other thing you look for are terms such as still air or quiescent air. Then you determine the geometry, calculate the Rayleigh number, choose the appropriate correlation, and then solve for our H. One thing also to keep in mind is that all the properties are calculated at the film temperature, which is Ts plus T infinity divided by 2, where this temperature is in Kelvin. So in future screencasts, we'll take a look and use some of these correlations in a practical application.